Okay, I've got a little project I've been wanting to work on for quite some time now. Ding dong, visitors. It's going to require some... Wow, double visitors. Or do we just have one overzealous? Now we have double visitors. That's the first time we've had double visitors. Anyway, we're going to need a lot of witherers, a lot of torches, some chests. We're going to need a ton of soul sand, which we're going to get once we go out there. And we're going to need a lot of glass. If I could actually click on these, clicky, clicky. Throw them in the smeltificator. Bop, 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 and bop. And wait a few seconds. And here it comes. Dropping from... I love this smelter. I just love how it's all underground and it just smelts so fast. Glass is coming in, like 20 a stack. There's half a stack, half a stack, half a stack, half a stack. Just so fast. I love it. So I'm taking all my bits I just made and we're heading out to the nether here to the Soul Sand Valley. Right around here. Like my Piggy Wiggy farm. Can I get some chunks over here? There we go. Man, it took forever to load some chunks. Anyways, my, there we go. There's the happiness right there. So that's right there. Over here, this beam is Impulse's Wither Skeleton farm. I'm going to build a Ghast farm today, right up on top of this thing, probably like right around here. All right, I got to fly over here now, pick up a whole ton of soul sand. Now, making gas farms in 116 is just ridiculously easy. Hello, hello, hello. How about that? Click. Thank you. There we go. That'll do for now. Making gas farms in 116 is crazy easy, and I'm going to show you how to do it. And it literally is just any size you want. This is like a 10-minute project. Oh, this is better. This is better. I found a spot over here just under my gold farm right here. So if I, you can see I'm in the Soul Sand Valley right here. If I go over here, it turns to nether waste. And if I go over here, it turns to nether waste. But if I go in that direction and that direction, pretty much as far as I want, it's going to be Soul Sand Valley. So now if I AFK up there, my gas farm will be working right here. And my nether world will be growing. First, we're going to want to pillar up to about about 220 or so. Is probably good. Where are we at now? We're not even close. Okay, I think I need to gas-proof my nether ward farm. This is gonna be a problem here. Stop spawning. You too. So the plan is pretty straightforward here. I'm gonna have one layer, and this is just the arbitrary size I'm picking, but this whole thing is in the Soul Sand Valley. This is gonna be the base layer. I'm gonna fill this all in with iron block. This is gonna be for the minecart system to pick up all the gas tiers and gunpowder, and then we're going to take another layer on top of it like this and just mirror the whole thing up two blocks for the soul sand. This is for the actual gas to spawn on, but I'm going to get the whole minecart system in first. I don't have to be like all in like fly mode, like down here and stuff working because all right, so we got a little bit of track laid down here, and I'm super cheap because I'm almost out of redstone, so I'm really trying to cut corners on how many powered rails I need and stuff. So let's see here. We're going to go and I want to see if this is going to... Oh, come on, you can do it, you can do it. Is that not even a powered rail? Oh, how sad. Let's try it again, let's try it again. This time with much more power. And by much, I mean just a little bit. Oh, wow, it's so pathetic. Do hopper minecarts, whoa, do hopper minecarts travel faster than regular minecarts? Oh, they do. Look at that, I didn't know that. Okay, hopper minecarts. Super extra go-go power. Is this going to make it all the way back, though? Oh, yeah. These things fly. Okay. Goodbye. Okay, the minecart picker-upper system is in. Look at that effect. That's a very weird visual effect there. So this is it. It is pretty large here. My only concern is this actually less than 5 minutes? Like, if an item... Items only last 5 minutes. Is it less than 5 minutes for this cart to run this whole back and forth and drop off whatever it's picked up? I think this is about as big as it can be, but I'll have to run some timings. But that was the fun, boring, horrible part. So now we're going to get in the soul sand, and then we're going to talk about why this farm is so magical. Oh, is that not the most soothing sound you've ever heard in your life? I think I'm going to make that my new bedtime lullaby. I went ahead and finished the farm. So, this is it. Oh, God. Let me turn sounds down. Hang on. There we go. Hostile sounds completely. Look at this thing. It's amazing. What an easy farm to make. But it's very dangerous. I didn't exactly make this farm safe yet. Something's probably going to shoot me in the face. But anyways, it's very, very basic what you got to do to make this farm. Let me get up on top here. Otherwise, they will shoot me. So they spawn on the soul sand. We are in a soul. Yep, I don't want to be here. Camera count. Saving the day, as usual. Okay, we're going to have to use the camera count to show you how this farm works, because it's not exactly safe. I know I shouldn't close the whole thing in glass, but that's a lot of glass. Who's got time for that? So the way this farm works is pretty simple, actually. We're in a soul sand valley. The entire farm is in a soul sand valley, and there's basically only two mobs that spawn in that biome: gas and regular skeletons. So we have a soul sand platform here so that we can place the wither roses on it, okay? And we've lit it up just perfectly enough so that skeletons can't spawn on it. And the wither roses are placed just far enough apart so that no matter where a skeleton spawns, one of his bits is going to be touching a wither rose, like that guy right there. How unfortunate for him. So yeah, very straightforward. Wither, the gas spawns, the gas dies. The gas gets withered up and he dies in like 5 ticks or something like that. I don't know. It's super fast. And then, you know, of course, down below, we have this massive minecart that just keeps going back and forth. And my concerns were 100% valid. It takes almost 5 minutes just to do one loop of this farm. So I added a little loop back system right here. There's no real drop off now. It's just a whole bunch of these hoppers here that when they roll over all these, he drops all the items off. But he does one way and then he loops back this way and then does the whole system again in the same direction. So that's basically the farm. What else can you say? Little glass roof here to keep them from flying away. Walls to keep them from flying off the sides. You can see that guy spawned right on the edge. Still can't get off. Now, the rates aren't amazing, but they are definitely good enough for a ghast farm. I mean, already, can I open this and can I show this? Yeah, we already got that guy filled up. We already got this guy filled up, and the hopper's already filled up. So we got plenty of bits already here. Now, the one thing I realized after I made it was that I made it so close to this farm. Like, if I AFK over here, we can have both farms working, but I made another AFK spot over here for this little fool up in the sky here, and that makes the piglin farm, or the zombie piglin farm over here, just far enough away where nothing can spawn there, but the gas can still spawn. So basically, if I just want to do gas, I stand over there. If I want to do both, I would stand inside there. Works out pretty good. Now, you might be asking yourself, why are we building a ghast farm? And, well, the true answer is absolutely no reason whatsoever. However, I'd be lying if I didn't want to help out my buddy Zedaf here, because he recently made a... How do I get in? He recently made an amazing Brewificator System 9000 that I am going to attempt to use right now without breaking it. So I believe the way it works is you specify how many potions you want. I want 3, of course. Then you decide, do you want like plus time or plus potency? We're gonna make a plus timer. I think there we go. Excellent. And then you decide, do you want it to linger or do you want it to splash or whatever? Let's see what. And then you got to decide what potion you want. And he's got like this warning system here, which is crazy. The warnings pop up when the combination doesn't make sense, which is just ridiculous that he did this. Like, plus time doesn't make sense for harming or healing, of course, right? And then if I switch to, like, let's see, if I switch to, now we have plus potency, well, weakness doesn't make sense. All these don't make sense. So these combinations are crazy. So I love it. So let's see. I think I want... Oh, there it is. We want an invisibility potion because, you know, sometimes when we got to go inside decked out to get things fixed, it'd be nice to have one of those. So we're all set. We don't want splash. We want extra things and bits. And then watch this, right? We're going to hit this. Watch what happens right here. Eh. Wait for it. There they go. The bottles, the ingredients, everything just went flying in from outside the edges of the thing. All went in the correct order now, and it should be brofricating. There we go. We got another wart. And then I have no idea why the golden carrots for invisibility, right? It's all perfect. Fermented spider, is that correct?
Yes. You gotta do night vision, and then you invert it with the stinky eye.
And here we go. I think, yes, 3 potions of invisibility. That is such a cool system he's got here. Zed's doing all kinds. If you guys aren't watching Zed, you really are missing out. He's doing all kinds of crazy gadgets and stuff here. Everything he does is with like his own little personal twist, and it's just so entertaining. But anyways, he mentioned that. Where is the thing with the... That.
regen, right? It's hard to get ghast here, so we're gonna give him a little bit of head start on his ghastification. And there we go. Zedef, you kinda smell. Here are some tears. Now the other reason I built a ghast farm is so that I can start playing with these things again, because I love end crystals. You gotta be super careful with these things though, because their hitbox is much, much bigger than it looks. All right, so let's get some of these in here. Let's get another one there. Do that. And we'll get one more right there. Do that, I think. So these things used to be way cooler than they were. You used to, and I'm talking a long time ago now, they used to be able to, like, chain the explosions together, where if you hit one and another one was in the radius, they would all chain together. I think now all they do is explode the other ones, I think. Yeah, that's just such a letdown. It used to be so cool because you could have like this instant explosion that, and these would be amazing for mining ancient debris if that was the case. But either way, I'm going to find a project, something I could do with these things soon, because let's just face it, they're fun. So it wouldn't be an episode, of course, if I didn't stop by decked out, and I'm glad I did. Look, there's something's going on here. There's building afoot. Someone's doing some road work here. I guess it's not done, but I like where it's going. So let's talk about decked out and what's going on down here. Ow, that hurt. The game is popular. Mildly popular. I think there's like 147 hermits who have played now, give or take a few. But no, honestly, it is getting pretty, there's only a few people who haven't been down here yet, and I know those people have expressed interest. But here's the thing, there's like a lot of people playing. The game has been run, I think, how many times has the game been run? The game has been run 67 times now. 67 times decked out has been run. Now, some of those are, you know, shenanigan runs where things went wrong and I had to give a free key to fix it, but basically it's easily been run at least 50 times. And that's all we got. That's all we got. We got three sets handed in. So I'm doing something wrong. I've screwed this part up. There's not nearly enough sets being handed in. So we need to do something about that. So I think one of the first things I'm going to do is start sliding in a few more artifacts in each barrel, because sets need to be completed. I don't know what's going on. Maybe the uniques are just hard to find. I don't know. But here's the big thing I'm doing right here. Check this out. We got a daily auction for a wild card, okay? This is any artifact you want it to be. Throw it in with a set. It could be any unique. It could be a rare if that's all you're missing. It could be whatever you want. And I think that's pretty amazing. However, the auction has been up for over 24 hours and there is not a single bid. So this concerns me. I don't know what that means, but we need to get some points on the board here. Okay, what is Zed up to? Anyone want to prove their skills? Come now to Zed's base using Legend of the Impulses with bow and arrow poised, no touching the ground. Let's see what he's got in mind. He says no touching the ground. Can I not go into his base? Oh, there he is! There he is! What am I doing? Am I trying to shoot him? I got him! I got him! I don't know what he wants! What do I do? What madness is this? In the air, arrow the target, go in the door. Okay. Okay, that was cool. Did I do? I want to try that again. Here we go. Eek! Oh, I love it. Get him. That thing is amazing. So I got invited by Izuma to play his new game. It's like Lucky 13 or something 13. I don't know. It's like a 2v2 game where you got to go into this like maze and shoot targets. And they're all like these super trick shots and hard to get to and everything. Anyways, it was like me and Beef against Hypno and Cove, and we had a lot of fun. I'm going to show it to you guys.
Well, thank you, my fellow hermits, for turning up and giving a test run to the game known as L13, Lucky 13. Are you guys excited?
I'm curious.
Excited. Yeah,
I'm
very excited.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on. That's the enthusiasm I like to see. So I guess good luck.
Let's go.
Thanks.
Yeah.
All right, Tango, let's do this.
So right, Tango and Beef versus Cub and Hypno. Yep. Who wants the far side over there?
We'll take the far side. We'll take the far side. That's a strong side. That's a strong
side. That's a winning side over there.
We'll see.
Oh, wow. It's going.
3, 2, 1. Go. All right. Okay. Do we have a strategy?
Here, I'm going to go through the water run.
Okay. I'll do... Oh, there's the honey jumper. That terrifies me. I'm going... Let's see. I'm going to go into the magma area.
Was that enough? Yeah, I got one. Where's the other wall? Right here. Boom, I got two.
Well, you're amazing at this.
Oh, I'm a professional. Is there something back here? There is. Okay.
I can't tell if I'm even close or not. All right, I'm going in.
Did you do the honey jumper by any chance?
I saw that and I was afraid and I ran away.
I am also afraid, apparently. I didn't know you could do this, but you can. Okay. Come on. You could jump from the edge of honey blocks.
Got another one.
Oh, you're killing it.
Oh, that is so hard. Okay, I'm going way up to the top here. I don't even know what's up here. Oh, this is the honey drop one, I think. Target.
Okay.
That's the honey drop. Oh, this is going to be impossible.
Oh, this is frustrating. This honey thing is not fun. Okay, can I go here and then...
Nope. You get two shots at the honey drop. It's impossible.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I can't get up this final block. Or final couple blocks. Okay. Ugh, no, come on. Oh, this is brutal. I think I might quit on the honey dropper or the honey.
It's rough. I'll give it a go in a second. All right, I got one more.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I got a block. Okay.
Jump shot. They probably already got jump shot.
I got up to the top.
Yep, they already got jump shot. You got up to the top? Fantastic.
Yeah, I got another target. Can I hit another one? Oh, I can hit another one from here. I got another target.
I'm lost.
Dropping down. Let's see. I'm going to go up the stairs now.
I don't know what's left except for the honey jumper thing.
Really? There's two targets there?
Oh, wait. There's this water run. Did we do all that?
The water. Oh, I did the water run. Yeah.
It's all good? Okay. No. Oh, this is
one
the worst.
Point left.
One point left.
It's tied. Come on.
No, I can't get up the... Should I even be going up the honey blocks?
Where? No, no, no. I already got up there.
Okay.
Where's the honey
I don't
drop?
Know
is it over
oh,
here?
Oh, there's a honey drop. Yeah. Go straight up the ladder.
Okay.
Straight up that big ladder.
Go.
It's super hard. You basically get two shots. So we'll just keep looping this until one of us hits it.
And we got to face this way?
Yep.
All right.
Oh, you got to slide the honey.
Whoa. I was wondering why that did so much
it
damage.
It makes it a little bit more difficult that way. Oh, wait. Oh, this one way
oh, wait.
Up there.
Now you got to go back around the lava thing? Is that how you get back up?
Me.
You have to, like, walk through the ice?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, this is brutal.
Okay, there's one left, and it's way up high. As you're doing the honey drop, look up. It's basically an impossible shot. We might be here for 20 minutes.
And that's the only one left. Okay.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, show me how it's done.
Okay, right.
You gotta jump on the thing. Okay.
And way up there.
Where is it? Oh.
It's way up there. I don't think I got it. I totally missed. I don't even know how close I am. I think I missed by about like 50 feet.
50 feet? That's a long miss. Got to eat some food on the way up the ladder. That's a good strat.
That's optimal, right?
Yeah. Okay, doing this again. Honey drop. Is that what? I guess both teams are going for
right
now. Oh,
we're way too high, yeah.
I may have hit... No, I hit the target, but not the center.
Oh! All of my shots are way too high, I think. Because there's a lot of arrows stuck like 10 feet above the target.
It's okay. They're having the same problems
yep,
as we are.
Yep, they're having the exact same conversation right now. I guarantee it.
All right, doing it again.
It's hard to zero in because I can't see the results of each shot. So every time I go, it's just a fresh guess.
I'm sure X is just laughing it up right now.
Oh, that was horrible. Oh, that was close.
Once again. Oh,
GG!
Who got it?
Did you get it?
Who got it? No, I didn't.
Let's say you did.
I don't think. Oh, no!
Oh! That was amazing. What a relief. That was such a hard shot.
That was tough, that final shot.
The honey drop.
The honey drop was nuts.
I hit the target once or twice, but it wasn't close enough.
Don't think I even hit the Blackstone.
I think what I'm going to do is make that shot easier and a lot of the other ones hard, because I got to see how that played out through the camera count. Mm-hmm. And... Cub and Hypno, you guys like soared in front and picked off a lot of shots down the bottom really quick. Mm-hmm. And then I think Tango and Beef, you came back because one of you did the honey drop. Sorry, the honey, the parkour
yes,
bit with the
that
honey
was,
drop.
Yeah,
Beef
yeah,
did that.
Yeah.
Thankfully.
Yeah, and then well that paid off and kind of brought you back into it. And it literally was just the one thing at the end left. And then it felt like you and Tango Beef figured that out first. And then like 2 or 3 minutes later, Cub and Hypno figured out that was like the last one left. Yeah.
This is a great concept though, man. I gotta say.
Yeah, that was
a lot of fun. Definitely.
I'm glad you guys liked it. I feel like I can make what's here better with a couple of tweaks.
Mm-hmm.
And
100%,
you know,
yeah.
And then make something even better in the future. But yeah. Awesome. Thank
it's
you
exciting.
For playing.
Well done.
Thanks for having us.
All right, guys, that is going to do it for today. I want to thank every one of you guys for all the positive feedback, pretty much everywhere on Twitter, on Reddit, everything, all the positive feedback for Decked Out. It really seems everybody really enjoys Decked Out and really enjoys watching all the Hermits run it. And I just want to say thank you because that just makes me happy. That was the entire point of the project. So I'm hoping we can keep the game running a few more weeks and hopefully we can get the interest where it needs to be and hopefully we get some scores racking up here. But guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.